Namaskaram. Namaskaram. Thank you so much, Radhika.
Please stay tuned.
Great opportunity. I'll be always in tears because...
Please stay tuned.
One second.
Please stay tuned.
Welcome. Radhika, thank you so much for this lovely opportunity. As I told you, whenever it's Master Nata, I will always cry or I'm always emotional because whatever I am today is because of Master Nata. It's not that I'm famous or anything, but they made me from zero to a hero. Everyone tells I'm a very confident person, but when it comes to Master Nata, I don't know how I lose that confidence, but I'm very emotional all the time. Master Nata, thank you so much for everything you have done. And I'm very proud to be alumni of Bandiklanjali. To this many, I have lot and lot of love and support from all of our seniors, even the juniors. Few months ago or few years ago, even, you know, middle of me sharing my knowledge, I had a small doubt. I called Lataka. She just told me, Sri Lataka, you know, my, the Alapadmante Yateyi and Satyajit, Anupama, I'm very blessed in this birth to be part of Bandiklanjali, as well as, you know, my pride is saying I'm the disciple of Dhananjayans. And that will go to my grave. Thank you so much. Today I'll be dedicating our Vandana with Master's grandchildren, Master Naka's grandchildren, Gayatri, Madhumita, Nidusha. Please bless us and be with us always. And to all my Bandiklanjali family, I love you. You are the best. Bless us and stay safe. We start this evening with the Nadaraja Anjali. All of us, including myself, we learned it when Master Naka was here in Melbourne, I think back in 2009. And still we talk about the memories, how Master was excited to teach us because he has lot and lot of local students, and he, Master Naka, was so cute. So enjoy. It will be performed by Gayatri Ilambo. Thank you. Memories are still fresh because it was taught by Anitaka, who dear to myself. I still owe a lot to Anitaka. Thank you so much, and we will be doing a Jatiswaram in Ragam Poli Talahani. 1994. I'm just repeating today because I was cherishing all the memories because I learned this item one with master. I've been cherishing this memory, being, you know, very possessive, not even sharing with my children. So after doing today, I may share it. I'm just very possessive about this dance. Masanaka, really sorry, I didn't practice well, but forgive me, I'll do better in the future.
तेरे दिल बारानो Thank you. Thank you.
honestly, it's an opportunity for me to get back to Nagyam after many months. I want to do more. Me, my children, we seek Santaka Dhanamasi's blessing as well as all our seniors at BK. Please bless us and stay safe. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Radhika Mahadeva. That was a very beautiful presentation. All your sincerity and your Guru Bhakti came across so beautifully. The next artist for us guest is Shrimati Anita Vallabh, a very versatile, multifaceted personality. Anita Vallabh, PhD, is a widely traveled Bharatnatyam dancer with 30 years of teaching experience and also a certified yoga teacher. She received her doctorate in semiosis of Bharatnatyam from the University of Madras in 2002. She pursued her dream of a holistic performing arts school with Aika Academy, where children and adults of all age groups had the opportunity to learn drawing, painting, classical dance, music, clay modeling and sculpture. In 2005, at the Village International School, Bangkok, she reworked her understanding of movement vocabulary for a sustained intervention program for children with autistic spectrum disorders, ASD. She has choreographed many group productions and presented papers at Kyoto University, Japan, University of Hawaii, International Sanskrit Conference, Bangkok, University of Culture, Myanmar, and York College, Pennsylvania, to name a few. In 2008, she published Message in Movements, Essence of Bharatnatyam, and in 2012, the second edition called Abhinaya Darpanam. Anita is the recipient of the National Award for the Best Dancer from the National Hindi University, Calcutta, and was conferred the title of Kala Bharati. In recognition of her work in propagating the art form in the schools at Yangon, the Tamil Association in Myanmar conferred upon her the title Bharatanatya Pracharamani. In 2011, she received Certificate of Honor from Council of City and County of Honolulu. She presently resides in Boston, USA, and is working towards two publications in 2021. Patanjali's Vision, What We Learn and How It Is Seen in You and Me, an Insight into Creative Living. Okay, we have a brilliant speaker, a research person, and a brilliant dancer. So let us quickly add her. Sanita, waiting for you to join. Yeah, it is very nice that she is visiting Chennai now, and we could catch hold of her now. Anita, we are waiting for you. Hi, Namaskar, Anita.
Namaskaram.
Namaskaram. You may have to adjust your camera.
Akka, the audio is not very loud for me. I'm going to adjust. I'm on full. Okay.
No, you can wear your earphones.
I'm good now. Namaskaram, sir, Akka, all Sahrudayas, my colleagues, my friends, brothers, sisters, everybody, Radhikata's fans. Everybody, vanakkam. So happy to see
you. So good to see you, Anita. So nice. It was very interesting and a lot of things that I didn't know about you. Reading your profile, awesome. You've come a long way in your Natyam. Congratulations. Kudos to you.
You are my teacher, Akka. You are complimenting yourself. You were my teacher growing up. Akka were there in and out, but you were consistent in my formative years. Thank you, Akka, for all you have done for us.
Okay. And now I would like you to talk briefly about your early years at BK. At what age you started? I think you started with your sister, Sunita.
Yeah, so, sister and brother.
Oh, okay, yes. But did he continue dancing?
No, he left because at that time there were not too many male dancers and all his friends were teasing him. So at that time, Master Sir's presence as a male dancer was not so strongly felt throughout you know, every strata of society at that time. Now, okay. Sir's name is ubiquitous for being a man and a, you know, brilliant dancer and so many other things that sir does. But at that time, not so much so Krishna left, but Suni and I continued and we did our Arangetram together. The reason we joined Bharatakalanjali was just the practicality. Sir was my neighbor in the same neighborhood. And it was complete Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnoha, Smaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Andamari or Bhakti.
Navavida Bhakti.
Navavida Bhakti Ange, because we heard of him. And then whatever we heard about him, it was always Kirtanam. And then, so my parents just joined us there.
Okay.
But I always liked movement. I liked movement, not necessarily Bharatanatyam. But I would have been happy if it was Kathak or any other Natya tradition. Just so happened that, you know, when destiny wills, you follow the path. So sir was there, Sendhaton. And from there on, I was 4 and a half. I think I always wanted to be a dancer, but how seriously, I didn't know until actually maybe 20, 25 years ago. I came into it with a stronger purpose within the Natya sphere only in the last, I want to say, 25 years.
No, but it always happens, Anita, it always happens in the initial stages. You don't know the greatness of the art or anything. It's mere adavus and yeah, it's a physical workout. Plus, it's nice going to a group class and you have fun times. But it's much later that you realize a lot of things. Right?
Yeah. When
and in which age did you do your Arangetram?
18. 18. Okay. Sir used to be very strict that you had to have so many years of practice and so many years of performance experience. By the time we did an Arangetram, it was just a formality.
Yeah.
Because it is not like it was not, even for you, Noaka, by the time you did your Arangetram, you would have...
My 100th performance was
Arangetram. There you go. And actually, Radhika did a fantastic job just now. And it was so wonderful to see it do the same Jatiswaram that you taught me for my Arangetram and then I taught it to her.
Oh, okay.
You know, it was nice. It was an excellent
cycle.
Example of how the traditional Bharatakalandri tradition is just passing down. Yeah, and now I actually, believe it or not, Akka, I am a grand teacher for some of the students in the United States. That is my student Arangetram I have been to, and
okay.
It just feels like first generation Bharatakalanjali.
Super.
You can't, the same aesthetics on stage, everybody starts on time. I mean, it is such a classic Bharatakalanjali way of doing it that there
time.
Is a
whether there is
aesthetics
audience
on stage.
Yes, master will start on the.
If the chief guest doesn't come on time, too bad. You just, you know, it's for the chief guest to be embarrassed that he's walking in late when the performance is already, you know. So
yes.
It is in the, you know, I can't even believe I'm a grand teacher. But so that has been just wonderful. And also one of the things I was just, in fact, thanks to this media where we are able to share our thoughts. From the time I'm four and a half, I'm 52 now. I have not learned or seen anything from any other teacher ever. I do not know how any other teacher takes a class. I have never been to any Natya camp. I don't know how another teacher teaches, Akka. In all these years, I didn't go for Abhinaya classes or Natvanam classes or Natya Shastra camp or Abhinaya Darpanam. Appu sir used to not be happy. He used to say, go, you have to experience different teachers. You have to have this experience. Appa, I didn't know how to articulate it. But now I can say I was so completely fulfilled in Bharatakalanjali.
Yes.
And for me, there was nobody you could have even made me say would be a better teacher than sir with Abhinayam. I can argue that point. But more now I have come to know this is my point of view, that just observing sir. He doesn't have to take your class. Observe him in class. You can't find
very true.
You cannot have a better teacher. And Natvangam, I had Chantaka there.
No, it was complete training, Anita. complete training. There was no need for anything else.
It would have only confused me, if anything. So, and also, either way, we have not even, we don't still have even the quarter of what they have, right?
Exactly, exactly. There's so much to learn. Right. All your lifetime, you're learning, yeah.
Right. And also, what happened is my greatest influence, Akka, is not actually the performing arts. எனக்கு நாட்டியம்ன்றது now at 52, what I learned as in as நாட்டியம் is absolutely nothing compared to how the way sir taught. Sir always connected Shastra to Prayoga. Always. That I did not realize until now when I'm doing all my research work, how for me, the relevance of any text till today is only in its practice. If I cannot practice it, it does not work for me. I will not speak about it because I don't have the experience of it, neither in my body nor in my mind. So it is out. And because I didn't go to any of these camps, I don't have so much vast knowledge of scriptures, but just trying to understand four verses, yato hasta tato drishti, for me is the yoga of natya, the natya sadhana. Everything comes in those four verses. I know little, but I want to know more of that little. Because for me, just practicing that itself, that, and you know, he used to constantly say this, acharya padam atate padam shishya samede, all, you know, what you learn quarter here, what you learn through experience quarter, that itself was enough, he used to say. And appo at the 10th time he said is, we all used to roll our eyes, you know, sir idhe solittu irukku pora irpa nu, but that got so deeply ingrained into my psyche that I'm thinking, how much more can I observe, how much more can I experience before I even put it into writing? Because writing is a tradition where 100 years from now somebody is still going to see my writing, my dance will be forgotten, but writing for me is sacrosanct. And so I have to be very careful what I say, and it all comes from the experience of imbibing a text. It can be just four verses, but know it well. It comes from sir. That is one thing, and so this has nothing to do with how I do a Ramavarna. You see, and another thing, Chantaka apparently told sir she's writing well. Ask her to pursue that a little more. Chantaka, I love that. Please tell it to Vitruvanga. But it has such a deep impact that I started thinking, maybe I should do this, because I have never thought of myself as so much
a writer.
I've been more a seeker always. I didn't know it that time, but I wanted to know more, not necessarily perform more. I really never cared about the performance aspect after a point.
No, but Anita, sorry for interrupting, but you were a very brilliant performer, giving many performances. At which age did you get into this mindset of?
Akka, eppome irundhadakka. Every time I did not recognize it. It was every time sir went on to the stage, for me it was just a focus. Everything he says keeps coming back to me. So that seed, he not only planted it, but he also nurtured it enough. It germinated and became what it is now, perhaps in the last 15-20 years, because my research required that I step out of the performance arena to have a more objective approach to what I was going to write. Because if I am performing, then I become the subject. I can't do a third person look into what.
So these days you are not performing?
Not like a kacheri, because until 21, Akka, once I finish this, then I'll have, because I have to be absolutely true to what I'm writing. And when you take natyam as a sadhana, it's very hard to bring in the performance aspect where aharyam is involved, where I have to be in a multimedia platform. I cannot be isolated and not be on Facebook and this and that and be of, you know, any success, because that's where people are looking now, right? Organizers and conference seekers are all looking at your profile, your social media profile. So I'm still into that old school of sending an email. For me, if I can do that, it's very efficiently, it's fantastic. But it's just fantastic, Akka, that I'm in such a wonderful happy, fulfilled place in my life and in my heart, I'm able to embrace so many things and be so happy for what everybody else is doing.
You know? So good. So happy to hear this, Anita. I'm so happy for you.
Thank you, Akka. Thank you, Akka.
Tell me a little more about your doctorate. What was it about?
Akka, my doctorate was changes in Natya, in the dance structure and form because of changes in society. Again, okay. This is thanks to all the, you know, I don't like to say brainwashing, but the way sir used to always talk about the Shastra Prayoga, that for me, again, I saw how much society influences the dance form and content and how much is generated by us, right? What is it that I want to do if, say, some organizer didn't say, I want you to do in something on women? Am I doing it because they're asking me? If nobody asked me anything, what would my dance look like? That has been a lot of my research in the last 15 years. If I don't have a performance, what does my dance look like? If I don't have somebody else telling me how I should parrotify my mutti or whatever the technicality involved, what does dance really mean to me will only came to me when I stopped everything and I did it only for myself. And I feel now I'm at my best because I'm doing it for myself and I'm doing it for something deeper in me, grander outside me. And it's just a phenomenal experience, Akka. Just even a padam takes on so much of, so many dimensions come, you know. It's just amazing what that panoramic view of every javali or padam. I love javalis. Because it brings up.
Is it because you're familiar with the language? Because most of the javalis.
100%. I'm not, my mother is, but she gives me a layered understanding and I have a natural flair for it. That is one thing, but also there is that mischievous, sensuous, naughty side in me that used to be there when I was younger, that comes out when now as an adult I do it. You know, so I still like those little glances because it reminds me of being
the childhood days.
So that's why I think that's why it works well even with children with special needs at that. Just the emotive, I think the strength of Natya traditions in India is the emotive aspect alone singularly works across all cultures. Across all cultures, Abhinaya is the foundation and the citadel, according to me. Because
you have a natural affinity and preference to Abhinaya over Dritta, right?
Simply because it works at a deeper level. It impacts people more. For example, you know, you can, Sirs Nandanar is definitely more impactful than his world famous Atana Varnam or Bihar. Sir will still, he'll always be remembered for his roles as Dasharath and Nandanath because it makes you feel
it touches your heart
about how you treat other people because racial prejudice, cognitive biases, cultural biases exist in every conversation. You know, when people think I've come from the US, somehow they'll feel better if they put one culture down to make another culture feel better. Right there is a bias there. Right? So when you do something like Nandanar, it cut across all those biases that we see till today of color, of race, of gender, you know. So, and the Bhavam is such a universal idea, it's such a brilliant conception because feelings is universal, right? And and it's kind of exciting that when you teach a foreign audience, getting them, Italians are very easy because culturally they are very loud. And they use their hands and legs and body a lot. But otherwise, for people to come out of it, I have had students who sweat after one teaching of Javali class because of the intensity and the layers in the emotion. They sweat. They don't even understand why they're sweating because they're engaging themselves that much more. Now, Nritta, if I just glance like this and do this, I can go without feeling anything. But Bhavam, there's no chance.
Would you say then Nritta is devoid of emotion? it still conveys a lot of emotion.
Intensity, Atha. I'm talking about intensity.
No, even Nritya can be very intense. And that is why some of the dancers are so brilliant when you can make out an intense performing artist with her looking at a Nritya also.
If
or a dancer who is just technically right.
Right. Atha, I'm saying is 30 minutes of just doing Nritya alone. No Abhinaya. And 30 minutes of just doing Bhavam alone, presented to an audience that has no understanding of Natyam, they will relate automatically to the Bhavam.
Yeah.
They will connect with it. This is what I'm saying. So it depends on what your intention is with the art you have. What do you intend to do with it? What is the Sankalpa? Sankalpa is there, Vikalpa is there, Nirvikalpa, all will follow through, right? But what is the intention you have will inform the rest.
True. Okay, now that you you told me that emotions are universal and they are also timeless, irrespective of the place, irrespective of any part of the world, the emotions are the same. Have you ever tried contemporary poetry? Like you said, I'm working on dance, getting reflected. Reflection of the society. Have you tried any contemporary literature into Natyam?
No. I am a huge fan of Tyagaraja Kritis, Annamaya Sankirtanalu. I am such a huge fan of our own songs. Again, if somebody said there is something here that is not here, I will explore it. But I have not shown any interest to go in trying somebody do an English poetry, for example, because
not English, but contemporary literature.
Whatever, because it not only in English, not only whatever language that one is living in. Now, if I lived in Germany, if I did something in German, they will understand it. But that has not been my experience. My experience is people have absolutely loved. But then I also talk a lot at that. For me, 50%, I have the audience with me by the time I've spoken about that one Padam or Javali I'm going to do.
Okay.
Right. So I don't have so much confidence in my Natyam so much. So I give only 25% for them to reserve judgment for my caliber as a Natyam. But here is where I try to, you know, turn them around to my side and my way of presenting. Because I think that is my strength. I present it as my experience and they immediately come into it because they don't know the language, but they understand the emotion. You know, and especially Geeta Govinda's Ashtapadi is always a hit. Always, this Yahi Madhav is always a hit, right? People always understand a woman asking a man to leave the place and
get out.
Even as you announce it, you get claps. And it's always from the women. Because half of them, they really want to do that to their own whatever relationship.
Yeah, true, Akka, very true.
I have a question for you, Akka.
Yeah.
Tell me, where you got this idea, Akka, to have these performances now? Why? What was your intention? Because this is a particularly difficult times for a lot of us in terms of space and going to finding a space, especially if we don't have good music. But still people do it because of, you know, they most of them cannot say no to sir. And also it's an opportunity for them to think about how they...
No, there are a lot of people who had put on Chalange only for this show. During the pandemic. Well, Anita, I have always, I am a diehard fan of music and Natyam.
Oh, yes.
Always trying to experiment with new concepts. Yes. So I started off with a music show called Raga Darbar. Every Thursday it goes. And every week there's a musician who will explain a raga, the Arokna Varaguna feel of the raga and sing a Kriti in that raga. So that I have been doing for almost a year now. And then I started this Nritya Upasana because I wanted to see Natyam. And social media is the best platform now. Okay, with its plus and minus, when there are no opportunities in the sabhas,
absolutely,
even good performers don't get opportunities to perform in sabhas and nothing happening over the year. I thought it would be nice if I start something like this where dancers could share their art with me. Now I started off therefore about 4 months I did just dancers, good dancers across the globe. Then I did a tribute, Natya tribute to Sarasa teacher. All her students, Urmila, Shailaja, everybody, Lavanya, everyone came forward to pay the tribute to Sarasa teacher. Simple reason being I should have done master first, but I wanted to start master on a Vijayadashmi day. Wow. I started Natyam with him on a Vijayadashmi day. So I did Sarasa teacher before that, and then on Vijayadashmi day we started this Guruvanda, and surprisingly this goes on till July. Wow. I am just hoping I make it till next Vijayadashmi, then it will be a record of doing one year of alumni of BK, because he has touched so many artists and so many people across the globe. But unfortunately, a lot of people are unable to do it for various reasons. If they all come together, we will do it for a year, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Right now, till July, I have another 3 more months.
I'm sure a lot of them, and things get a little better when they can step out of their, you know, very small houses or something.
Yes, yes, yes. No, I'm saying even if you have a very small living space, okay, you speak about master, you speak about what you learned, and do a padam. It's not necessary you do a varnam to prove yourself.
Right?
Running around or doing a kilana.
It's not about
like, I'm coming to your point. Even an intense abhinaya can touch people, right? You can stay close to a camera and work on your face, which was also part of training at Bharatakalanjali. Now, this is how we started, and it has become a hit, and I'm happy. I'm connecting all BK students through this show, wherever they are. And it started mostly as a satisfaction for me to see everyone perform and share their thoughts. But now it is going globally also. I'm happy about it. But Anita, now tell me about your...
I'm going to add to this. I'm just so... for me, it's just mind-boggling, because I'm not in this media itself, that you got so many people involved in this. And you know what you have actually done? From a third person looking in, it's like what that concept of yajna used to be, where everybody... In my village, for example, when they do a sacrifice, a yajna, with a pit and a sacrificial pit and everything, everybody in the village, I was, I think, 12 or something in Dimili, everybody brought in some food, and some people who's cleaned up the place. Every person contributed something. And there was absolutely no expectation of a return or a reward. They did it because they wanted water to come to the village. For a common good, every villager contributed to it. And for me, that was such a striking later. Of course, everything is reflecting now, is the concept of yajna is when all of us come together to show our love and respect for Guru, and you are the conduit. And that becomes a yajna, because really nobody is expecting anything out of this. Right?
Sure.
And it's, sure. I just want to point this out to all those who are participating, or even people who are unable to participate, right? That just being in ways you can be, is just a phenomenal.
That's what I'm telling Anita. I know you have medical issues. I know you'll have practical difficulties in performing. But why not come on live and speak? That even for 5 minutes, even for 10 minutes to, I think it's a blessing to even say that I learned with the Dhananjayans. I am their disciple. Even to say that, I think that's a periya bhagyam illaya. Just that. Adhu solradhukku kuda, I don't know why some people are not coming, and I hopefully they'll come. See, immediately when I say do something, immediately they are thinking of Natyam, performing. Oh, I'm out of Natyam, I'm not been performing. I say, no need. If you're an artist, you're an artist throughout your life.
Yes.
It's not that you practice. I'll tell you, the foundation that we had at Bharatakalanjali, an amazing foundation, that even students who have not been dancing for 10 years, 15 years, they have come up with such brilliant presentations.
But Akka, I have to tell you, Akka, you made classes so much fun for us.
Really, I don't even remember.
Are you Akka? It is phenomenal. Because I remember, before class, we will run to check who's coming to teach us.
Yeah.
First priority was you because class would be just super fun.
Oh.
Shantaka was, yeah, then we had to, you know, really work a little bit more and be more, a little more. Sir was, oh my goodness, sir will be searching for Devika Akka to put her in the front to ask all the questions because sir loved it when he asked questions. Right?
Yes.
Right? Your class also, right?
No, this is nice to hear that because V.A.K. Rangarao always called me UV teacher. That means Uiravangra teacher. So I thought I was always very strict with students and I was not the fun-loving type.
Not at Bharata Kalanjali Akka. Not when we were growing up. Maybe later when you became, I don't know. But growing up, you made it fun for us. And we needed that balance, you know. We needed to know that there was a teacher we could go to, you know.
No, it is fun now in my school too. Oh,
I'm
my
sure.
Students are my best friends. They talk, they confide, they share secrets. That's how.
Isn't that something, Akka, that we have that because of Bharata Kalanjali, the other collateral blessings we have had is the friendships. Till today, Ade Sangeeta, Aparna Yamini, and Aparna Ramaswamy, they are my 2 AM friends. I'm in trouble. They are, and it's all because we all have the shared experiences at Bharata Kalanjali.
Yes.
Of practicing together and, you know, being playful together.
Yes.
All that, right? Till today. And that's another huge thing that our friendships were formed until today, they are sustaining us. And it's
yeah, and all the tours that we had with at Bharata Kalanjali. Can you talk about the tours and the group work that we did? We all did together. We have traveled. In fact, you have traveled with me as one of the trio sisters to Babylon.
That was phenomenal, Akka. That was phenomenal. I don't know, Akka. I, you know, it's just amazing how much I love traveling, maybe because of that, and how much I look for a cultural learning experiences wherever I go.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, in Baghdad, just going to that museum soon after the war and mm-hmm. presents Natyam and somehow connect in our psyche with what is going on outside and what we are presenting and how you presented it was such a learning experience. Because I think you also are so influenced by the way you present it, right? By the time you're done talking, people are already, she's fantastic. So they have already assumed you're very good. So
hey, all from Master, yeah. All from that BK only. How to present shows,
well,
all learning from there.
That strategy works for me. You know, not very strong dancers like me, it works very well. That, you know, we have some gift. Like sir used to say, know your strengths and work with it, right? It's to know your strength and then work with it.
That's the biggest realization, Anita. That's the biggest realization in life.
But I enjoyed the discipline of working. It was a lot of hard work and a lot of fun. We always got pocket money. Who gives pocket money? And enough to, you know, buy stuff for our family. We always got generous amount of pocket money. In fact, when I toured with sir separately, wherever we are, and after some time we'll go separately because I'll have some cousin arranging some program at a temple, he will call and check and say, do you have money? Are you okay? You know, sir always had that.
And they were more like parents. You can't call them master in a car. They are more like parents, you know. They made sure that we ate and
everything in the place. Otherwise, it was not just ate. Couldn't waste because, you know,
yes.
That concept was not something sir ever allowed us to do. Till today, I do that, Akka. Till today, I have grandchildren now. So with them also, I'm still, you know, it's going to go on in, you know, in a big way. And we don't realize it. Akka, here is the thing. I always, with sir, it was always, I love my relationship with him because I could always argue with him. You know, and it was just very comfortable. I don't have to agree to what they said.
Yes,
and I like
yes.
That. And so I never realized how I spoke about sir and Akka, especially sir, until this is a memorable incident that I feel compelled to share. I was at Kalakshetra one day, and we had just finished watching a performance, and my daughter at that time was 8 years old.
Okay.
So she had also come with me. So we came out, Sharda teacher was coming in front of us. And so I introduced, I said, Namaskaram teacher. And the, you know, after the initial courtesies, I said, Shraddha, this is Dhananjayan Tata's teacher. I introduced Sharda teacher. Okay. And she suddenly, she looked up and she said, Dhananjayan Tata has a teacher? She said. Until then, I didn't realize that I always spoke of Sir and Akka with such reverence that for my daughter, there was no teacher that could have been better than them.
Mm-hmm.
You see? And for me, until then, I didn't realize it myself. Because until then, when I am not happy with them, I do that sometimes with them or with our friends. You know, Sir, ipdi solitar, apdi solitar, all that. But I didn't realize that the essence of my feelings was translated and transferred to my child in a way that she was shocked that her Dhananjayan Tata could also have a teacher.
Teacher, ah.
Ah, I mean, like, she was like one ascharyam, you know.
Oh.
Yeah, that for me was, and another, one more, Akka, because I think we are running short of time. Just one more that I want to say is, my arangetram with Natwangam started with Lakshman sir singing and me doing Natwangam in Texas because the musician couldn't come on time.
Okay.
So sir gave me the Natwangam 2 days or 3 days before, and they changed the varnam to Rupamuchuchi to make it a little easier for me. And he says, "Nee class eduthundirukke, you have been taking classes, you know how to wield the thattukai. Here is the Natwangam." He showed me how to do kidathukku perugidum. That's it. The three speeds, he made me practice. He says, rest will come. That was my arangetram with the Natwanga.
How nice. Such memorable incidents in life.
Of course. And having Lakshman sir next to you can, you know, work either way, because suddenly he'll turn around and say, "Hi, the part of the real money party." And I said, "I'm not a singer." But he will always scare you. You know, he has this... he's so funny. You never know whether he's serious or really.
Or he's joking.
Straight face Lakshman sir was, right? So yeah. It was just, so many memories to share, Akka.
Yes.
And thank you for giving this opportunity. And thank you, sir. Thank you, Akka. Namo Namah.
Thanks, Anita, for sharing all your thoughts. And it was so good talking to you. Stay blessed. Wishing you many, many more laurels. And here, like Anita said, everyone at BK should be sharing the social media, because when I go live, when you are live, I have about 20 to 30 people only watching. But once it is put on IGTV, I have close to 500, 600 people watching. And if we are good, I go up to even 1,000K. So it is like dancing for a packed auditorium. So even sharing your thoughts, sharing your memory, sharing your learning experiences would be nice. It's nice for people to know all the seniors who have learned and gone out of BK, made their own niche for themselves, like what you have carved a niche for yourself.
Akka, your one item, your favorite, it can be Padam, Javali, whatever that you have learned from Sir and Akka.
My favorite item, of course, Ashtapati.
Which one?
Yaki. Yaki.
Oh, okay. Is it because you did it, sir?
No, also Kuile. Kuile unak ananta
ko. Oh, Veerumba. Yeah. Actually, that became my favorite, watching you do it.
Yeah, because that was one of my favorite pieces, which I would end up. And another thing that he specially composed for me was Vani Rammanave. Na Priya Sakhi, for my Arangetram. That also... I won't forget it. They are very, very close to my heart. I can just do it now. I remember it so well. I mean, what I learned at Bharatakalanjali, even in my sleep, you wake up, I would be able to do. But what I choreograph, I won't remember the next day also. I have to write it down or videotape
Akka,
it. And
your Kuni Kaikeyi, and the Nirpamaka's Sakhiye Varnam, it's just amazing. And Aparna as Karuna, Lata, Srilata, Vinod, phenomenal.
There's so many. BK has touched so many artists in so many different ways. Now that I'm into media, well, I've branched out. I'm not performing anymore. but I'm teaching and choreographing. So Natyam, the learning of Natyam does make an impact and a difference in our lives. And I'm hoping all students at BK would take back the best like what we did from Master Anaka. Thank you so much, Anita.
Sir,
it's so
Sir Anaka, Radhika Akka. I'm going to have another upcoming argument with sir, because I'll think of him as sir or Guruji, depends on whom I talk, but he calls himself master.
Okay. Okay, Master Akka, thanks for watching.
Sir.
And thank you, Anita, for this beautiful conversation.
Pleasure is ours, Akka. Pleasure is ours. Thank you.
Stay blessed. Good luck. Thank you.